Hello everyone, it is Saturday, April 13th in the year of our Lord 2013. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always, wicked awesome. It is definitely Cinema Saturday, it's Shit Face Saturday, whatever you want to call it. And today's movie of the day is the movie of the week, the movie for Saturday, Dirty Dancing. That's right, you remember this song. Be My Baby, the Ronettes, 1963, an absolute classic of a song. We are dedicating today's show to Dirty Dancing, a fine, outstanding movie from 1987. It is not just a chick flick, because I love that movie as well, and I hate chick flicks. But, with that said, we've got an unofficial sponsor for today's show, a new one, right down here, yeah, Texas, where men are men and the bulls run scared. Folks, check it out, Big Johnson Liquor and Beer. This stuff is awesome. 325-795, big one. Oh, big one indeed. And Zach, I give you the love doctor salute because you're an awesome guy, and I will be back for more beer. Big Johnson, I've already liked their page as myself and as my Beer Song of the Day Facebook page. Put together nicely with my good friend Justin Dimmitt, the executive producer of the show, creator of the Beer Song of the Day Facebook page, and runs your hunk of the Baby of the Day album for you. Another shout out to my good friend Sarah Milligan, my executive director, executive chef for the show, providing recipes. She's also runs your Hunk of the Day album, graphic designer, art director. So, anyway, Big Johnson, check them out, folks. Good beer. Good luck finding the place. It ain't easy. 3351 Turner Plaza, Abilene, Yeehaw, Texas. That's right. Now, today's beer of the day is a beast of a beer indeed. I haven't had it in a while. One of my all-time favorites. Samuel Smith's Oatmeal Stout, Tadcaster, England. This is still the best beer, the best oatmeal stout I've ever had. Best straight up oatmeal stout. Love this stuff. And I haven't had it in a while, and I think I deserve to treat myself. Proper beer opening apparatus, proper technique. And a decent pop from my good friend Justin Dimmitt. Right into the true beer consumption apparatus, a pint glass indeed, from the 2011 British Beer Festival, London, England, where they had over 750 different types of beer. Oh, I was in heaven, and I got annihilated that night. I was schnockered beyond belief, folks. 45-degree angle right into the beer consumption apparatus right over the keyboard because I'm just that damn good. Look at that. Oh, perfectly poured pint indeed. Cheers and beers to all you. Prost, as they say in Germany. Kampai, as they say in Japan. It's a perfect beer. A plus, no question about it. Oh, I love this stuff. Truly a beer, a meal and a beer consumption apparatus, my kind of stuff. How about another song representing the soundtrack? Here's a good one. Big Girls Don't Cry, Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons, 1962. A good one indeed. Oh, yes. Now, we got some birthday shout-outs for all of you. My good friend, Bobby Herndon. Happy birthday to you, bud. Hope you're doing well. He follows the page. Him and I've never actually met Bobby before, but we've chatted up in the past. Big Farm Bureau nut. I don't have time to play the Farm Bureau anymore. But we've kept the friendship. I love my Mafia Wars, as you all know. And, Bobby, always a pleasure hearing from you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. You celebrate well and enjoy, and a big hearty cheers and beers to you, my friend. Next on the list, I do know this guy, and I know him well. A badass spark-chasing son of a gun I worked with in jolly old England. My man, Ken Kretschy. Happy birthday, you, bud. Hope you're doing well. You know I'm doing good. The Love Doctor's always doing good, man. If day ends in a wide period, it's a good day, period, dot, end of story. Ken, my friend, drop me a line. Let me know what's up. Haven't heard from you in a little while. And a big hearty cheers and beers to you. You celebrate well and enjoy. Next on the list. Now this guy's absolutely awesome. He flies on airplanes for a living. How cool is that? Wicked cool. My man, we know him as Digger. Terrell Frigate. That's why we call him Digger. Frittiger. Is it Frittiger or Frittiger? Either way, we know he's Digger because Digger's cool. And Happy birthday to you, brother. Hope you're doing well. Always a pleasure hearing from you. Haven't heard from you in a little while, but drop me a line and let me know what's up. And thank you for being there for my going away party when I moved from England down here to Yeehaw, Texas. Sometimes a job moves you to other places. That's what you gotta do. But boy, do I miss jolly old England. And I miss you, Digger. And my friend, you have a wicked awesome day. Enjoy your birthday. Party hard and enjoy. Celebrate like it's 1969. Minus the acid. Next on the list, a lovely cop that I know down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. Total sweetheart of a lady. Jyssika Lewis, happy birthday to you. And I just read that a whole bunch of your good friends, including our good friend, the lovely, total sweetheart, Donna Lehman, who gets a shout out as well. She's a true Texan girl. Or is it known as Western Louisiana? Either way, Jyssika, I know you're being spoiled the way you should be. Absolute sweetheart, great lady. You have a wicked awesome day. Hey, Donna and Jyssika, don't forget the song pop. Donna, a big hearty cheers and beers to you as well. But Jyssika, a big, big happy birthday cheers and beers. You two have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. And Donna, thank you so much for having me meet Jyssika. Because remember, a stranger is a friend you haven't yet met. And I'll never forget what you two did for us, bringing cookies to our area where we were working our butts off, and you brought cookies free of charge, looking out for us. That's what good people do. And cheers and beers to the both of you. All right. Birthdays are done. I'm going to bring out another song to keep the show rolling. Here's a classic. Do You Love Me? The Contours, 1962. Definitely another great one from the soundtrack. You broke my heart. Oh, yeah. Now, you didn't even. We have a one-year happy anniversary shout-out. And this one's near and dear to my heart, folks. I'm going to tell you why. As you remember, a year ago today, April 13th. Wow. Excuse me. I promise you I'm not drunk. Not even close to my first beer of the day. But I performed the wedding ceremony. I am a legally ordained minister, folks, as you well know. Anyway, flew down to Florida and performed the wedding anniversary on April 13, 2012 with my good friends Chuck Pope Jr. and his better half, the lovely, gorgeous Kristina Pope. And they are doing so awesome. They're living in Okinawa and got a baby on the way, I'm telling you. Chuck, Kristina, happy anniversary to you. I love you guys. I miss you. Chuck is a cop in Okinawa. How cool is that? Wicked cool. I worked with his dad in jolly old England, but he's a leader of men and women in it. He's living in Florida now. The entire Pope family. I mean, I can't say enough great things about that Pope family. They are all truly wicked awesome. Chuck and Kristina, a big hearty, happy anniversary. 1 year. This day, cheers and beers to the two of you. You have a wicked awesome day. Chuck, drink an extra for Kristina. I'm sure she would if she could, but she can't. Gotta take care of the kids. But you guys, I miss you too. I miss the whole Pope family. And you have a wicked awesome day. You know, that Pope family provided the largest studio audience ever for Beer and Song of the Day. Look up the April 13, 2012 edition of Beer and Song of the Day. We had a whole entire audience of about 20-25 people. It was amazing. All right. Now, we've got some trivia questions that we had over this week. And one of them was, in the movie Dirty Dancing, what was Baby's planned college major? Well, our good friend Kellie Floyd, she answered, but I found out she changed her answer. My admins were looking out for you, Kellie. Now, I appreciate it. And I'm going to give you a shout-out anyway, because, Kellie, you're absolutely awesome. And you're a good friend of my friend, the one, the only, Cousin Guido, Dennis Guidus, a badass crew dogger I worked with in jolly old Japan. And, Kellie, I haven't met you yet, but thank you so much for watching my show every day and supporting the page. And for that, got to give you a shout-out. You certainly deserve it. Cheers and beers to you, Kellie. You have a wicked awesome day, and hope you enjoy the show. All right. Now, The one that did answer it correctly. As I get to another song, here's a short one for you. We are going to bring out Stay by Maurice Williams and the Zodiacs, 1960. A classic indeed, a great song. A very, very popular tune from a great year, 1960. Now, my good friend Heather Murray, the better half of my good friend Mike Murray, a bubble-chasing son of a gun I worked with in jolly old England, a leader of men and women in it, but his better half, Heather, total sweetheart of a lady and absolutely beautiful. We miss you guys big time, Mike and Heather. But Heather answered it correctly before Kellie chimed back in. And it was the economics of underdeveloped countries was the major. And she wanted to join the Peace Corps. So there you go. Way to go, Heather. You get the Love Doctor salute. Awesome job. It was the economics of underdeveloped countries, and she wanted to join the Peace Corps. Whether she did, we don't know. But cheers and beers to you, Heather, and to Mike. And Kelly, a cheers and beers to you as well for chiming in. Thank you very much. I always appreciate it. Now, we have some more shout-outs. See, here's a good one. What kind of car does Johnny drive in the film Dirty Dancing? Well, our creator of the Beer and Song of the Day Facebook page, my man Justin Dimmitt, his dad, the outstanding Jeff Dimmitt, who I have yet to meet in person, and I really would love to meet someday. He chimed in well. As we bring out a song that, now, this song, this movie, did not take place in 1987. But, there are actually four songs on the soundtrack from 1987. And this one is one of them. It's a classic. Eric Carmen, who originally was lead singer of the Raspberries in the early 70s, he went on to an outstanding solo career, and this song was definitely awesome. Hungry Eyes, 1987, Eric Carmen, here we go. And Jeff, my friend, you really nailed it. You're like, that's an easy one for old farts. A 57 Chevy Bel Air. You're damn right, Jeff. Way to go. You get the Love Doctor salute, and it was a black 57 Chevy Bel Air, folks. And Jeff chimed in with a bonus question on that. And he said, how about a bonus question? Keeping the viewers involved. I love it, Jeff. Keep up the great work. He said, where was the gas cap? Now, my good friend Dan Butler, a daily viewer of this show and page, he chimed in. He said, he guessed it was behind the license plate. I thought it was, too. But according to my good friend Justin Dimmitt, who researched the answer, he said it was behind the left taillight. Wow, I did not know that. I need to watch that movie again. So, way to go, Jeff. Way to go, Justin. Dan, good try. I'm there with you, buddy, because that's what I thought, too. It probably was for most guys, but I think it was a trick that Johnny Patrick Swayze had. I don't know. I need to watch it again to see. But cheers and beers to all of you. Now, there was one more question put together by my great admins, Justin and Sarah. And this one was simple. What year did the movie Dirty Dancing take place? The first person chimed in, Carl Holland, said 1963. Way to go, Carl. Awesome job. A badass I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Somehow we only got three mutual friends. Sure, there's more that we know together. But Carl, phenomenal job, 1963 indeed, 50 years ago, 24 years ago from when the movie was released, obviously. And well done. Another viewer of the show, Daryl Malkus, said the summer of 63. He had to sum it up even closer. Way to go, Daryl. Awesome job. But Carl, you're the one to answer it, the question perfectly. You get the Love Doctor salute. Way to go, my friend. Daryl, thanks for chiming in and clarifying even better. What the hell, I'll give you a Love Doctor salute because you deserve it. And you haven't answered the question before, neither of you, Carl. Keep up the great work. And folks, please promote my page if you can. Beer and Song of the Day. Promote my YouTube show. YouTube.com/redbosox. That's R-E-D-B-O-S-O-X. Need all the help I can get. Reach out to others. It's all about good people helping good people helping other good people. And cheers and beers to all of you. Now I'm going to give two more shout outs real quick. One of them is my good friend, Becca Crouch. She's living in Kansas, otherwise known as Northern Oklahoma, originally from Buffalo, Oklahoma. Total sweetheart of a lady. And, see, she's chimed in whenever she can on the questions. And she absolutely, she is the one that recommended Dirty Dancing, by the way. And Becca, we're hooking you up. My admins and I had already planned on it. Excuse me. But we never made an official announcement. You requested it. You got it. Becca, way to go, girl. Why not a love doctor salute to you and a big cheers and beers. And I hope you get to watch this episode. Because this one's for you and for all the other fans of Dirty Dancing. And I got a special shout out in a moment. This shout out goes finally to my mom, Barbara Baker. My mom is absolutely awesome. Watches the show every day, promotes the show every day. And Mom, I know how much you love Dirty Dancing. I remember when we bought it in 1987 on VHS. And I remember you always say, Patrick Swayze, he's a hunk. I remember it was one of your all-time favorite movies, Mom. And this one, you should love this show. And I love you, Mom. Miss you. And Delilah and Farrah love you. And you know, you and Dad can always come down here to Yeehaw, Texas. Otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. You're always welcome to come visit anytime you want. And I hope you enjoyed today's show, because it is definitely a wicked awesome one. And we're going to bring out another song. How about Hey Baby by Bruce Channel, 1962. This one's a damn good song indeed. I think we remember what part of the movie this was. Oh yeah. So there's our shout-outs. Let's get to some random... Well, let's do some movie facts first. And thank you, Justin Dimmitt, for putting this together for me. Now, the song She's Like the Wind was originally written for a movie called Grandview, USA, but was later used in this movie, Dirty Dancing, instead. The song She's Like the Wind was co-written by Patrick Swayze with Stacy Weidlitz. And it was sung by Patrick Swayze and also featured Wendy Fraser. Throughout the film, Johnny and Baby always wear contrasting colors. Baby's usually wearing very light colors, and Johnny's usually wearing black or something very dark. Why? Because he can. Now, the dancing that Patrick Swayze and Jennifer Grey do during the love scene was actually the same dance that they did for screen tests. How about that? It was not originally supposed to be in the film. Hey, who says you can't change things up, right? In the scene where Johnny and Baby are practicing dancing, and she keeps laughing when he runs his arm down hers, that was not part of the scene. She was actually laughing, and his frustration was genuine. Wow, so he was actually getting pissed. But they liked it because it was effective. And her falling over in the scene was unplanned too. See, amazing how, you know, it's called, you know what they call that? Improv, baby. You don't always have to stick to the script. I certainly don't for my show. Now, while the exteriors and cabin scenes were filmed at Mountain Lake in Virginia, the lake scene was filmed at Lake Luray in North Carolina in October. There were no close-ups because the actors were so cold that their lips were blue. Wow. Now it makes sense. I thought it looked like it was cold in those scenes. Now we know. We all know the classic line. Nobody puts Baby in the corner. That was voted as the number 98 movie quote by the American Film Institute out of 100. So it's in the top 100 movie greatest movie quotes of all time. How cool is that? Wicked cool. Alright. We've got, I think it's time for another one. How about These Arms of Mine, Otis Redding, 1962. I remember this. This is the love scene between Johnny and Baby. Oh, Jennifer Grey. So gorgeous indeed. And what a gorgeous song by the late, great Otis Redding. One of his early hits. In fact, it was pretty much his first hit, really. Now, Jennifer Grey, at 27 years old, was 10 years younger than the character of Baby. During her audition, she had 5 minutes to prove she could play younger and that she had the moves for the role. Well, you know what? She obviously did. And she kicked ass. And she's 53 now and still looks fantastic today. At the beginning of the film, it is said that Baby will attend Mount Holyoke College in the fall. Well, her namesake, Frances Perkins, that was her name in the movie, Frances Perkins, was actually a graduate of Mount Holyoke in the class of 1902. Now you know. During the scene where Baby and Johnny are dancing in the woods and later in the water, since that part of the movie was shot in October at Mountain Lake, Virginia, which is when all the leaves on the trees started changing colors. The trees all around the lake and for that scene were spray painted green due to the fact that the time frame of the movie was set in the summer, as stated by my good friend Daryl. If you look closely during that scene in the woods, you can see leaves falling off the trees. This doesn't happen in the summer. Heh, I beg to differ. You ever been through a hurricane in the summer? Yeah, it can. Leaves do fall in the summer. But anyway, whatever. I know they don't normally fall. I get that. In the last scene, on-screen mom Kellie Bishop says of Baby's dancing, "I think she gets it from me." Remember that? Well, not so fast, Mom. Bishop was a well-known Broadway singer and dancer, but on-screen dad Jerry Orbach began his career in Broadway musicals, and the father of Jennifer Grey is Tony and Oscar winner Joel Grey. Their most famous Broadway musicals, A Chorus Line for Bishop and Chicago for Orbach, had a famous rivalry for box office receipts and awards when they opened within months of each other in 1975. So there you go. She got the dancing from Kellie Bishop and definitely from Jerry Orbach. And from her own dad for real, Joel Grey. And finally, the name of the resort that they stay at is called Kellerman's. And now you know. All right. Folks, you know, we've got some celebrity birthdays. We got random facts of the day. And then we're going to hit it home with the babe and hunk of the day. So how about another song in the meantime? As my papers go flying, those things happen when I've got lighting. Things open up. How about Love is Strange by Mickey and Sylvia, 1956, an absolute classic. An awesome song indeed. Definitely a pivotal song in the movie. Bear with me. Definitely one of the songs that personified this movie. We all know Jennifer Grey, Patrick Swayze, singing to each other. Mouthing, you know, doing some mouthing the words. We do have celebrity birthdays, though. In fact, on this day in 1743, the third president of the United States of America, Thomas Jefferson, was born. He passed away July 4th, 1826, at the age of 83. On this day in 1946, awesome soul singer Al Green was born. He's 67 now. Tony Dow, Beaver's brother, Wally, and Leave It to Beaver. Tony Dow, 68 today. How about Ron Perlman, 63 today. Just an absolute badass looking son of a gun. He's the biker Clay in Sons of Anarchy, as I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with that show, my wife included. On this day in 1970, Rick Schroeder was born. Of course, Ricky from Silver Spoons. On this day in 1983, San Francisco Giants badass Hunter Pence was born. He's 30 today, milestone birthday. The late, great Butch Cassidy. Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. Butch Cassidy, born on this day in 1866, passed away in 1908. One of my personal favorite actors of all time, Don Adams. Maxwell Smart, age 86. That's right, Don Adams, born in the state in 1923, passed away in 2005 at the age of 82. Also the voice of Inspector Gadget and Tennessee Tuxedo.
Yes, Mickey.
My good friends in Jolly Old England will be familiar with this one. Guy Fawkes was born on this day in 1570, the famous Guy Fawkes Day, and he was executed in 1606. 50 years ago today, chess legend Garry Kasparov was born. How about that? Hey, Uncle Paulie from Goodfellas. Paul Sorvino, he's 74 today. Yep, born on this day in 1939. Now we've got some random facts of the day for all y'all. We've got Tom Benson, a year ago today, the day that my good friends Kristina Pope and her lesser half of awesome man Chuck Pope Jr. got married. That was the day that Tom Benson, the owner of the Saints, bought the New Orleans Hornets for $338 million. Not a bad purchase. Not bad at all. All right, here's a gorgeous ballad that I think y'all can appreciate. How about In the Still of the Night by the Five Sands, 1955. Oh, yes. Lovely song indeed. All right. On this day in 1997, the Hartford Whalers had their last hockey game ever. Sadly, they became the Carolina Hurricanes. Hartford still misses them. Carolina deserved the team, but damn it, why'd you have to take the Hartford Whalers? On this day in 1986, the best basketball team in the NBA, the Boston Celtics, finished with a home record of 40-1 for the entire 85-86 season. Wow! Also on this day in 1986, Jack Nicklaus won the Masters Championship. It happened to be the 50th Masters Championship. And by the way, Jack Nicklaus holds the record to this day, the oldest to win a major at the age of 46. Oh, on this day in 1987, I went to Washington, D.C. with my 8th grade Washington trip for the Tisbury School, Virginia here, Massachusetts. I'll never forget that day, Monday, April 13th, 1987. On this day in 1979, the longest doubles ping pong match ever ended after 101 hours. Wow! I wonder if they played nonstop during that whole time. This is a huge one, folks. On this day in 1970, a lot of you remember Apollo 13, hell, the movie as well. But Apollo 13, the real Apollo 13, announces the ever-famous quote, "Houston, we've got a problem." I thought it was "Houston, we have a problem." I don't remember which one it was. Was it "Houston, we have a problem" or "Houston, we've got a problem"? Either way, yeah, they had a problem. Because an oxygen tank exploded while they were on their way to the moon. Wow. On this day in 1950, foul. The Baltimore Orioles had their first baseball game ever. They lost to the Detroit Tigers 3-0 in Detroit. On this day in 1953, the very first Milwaukee Braves game ever. They beat the Cincinnati Reds 2-0. On this day in 1914, the first Federal League game happened. Yeah, the Federal League. You had the American and National League and then the Federal League, which, oh, by the way, Wrigley Field was built for the Federal League. Federal League lasted for 2 seasons, but the Baltimore Terrapins beat Buffalo 3-2. On this day in 1912, another huge milestone, especially if you're English, British, whatever, the Royal Flying Corps formed. They later became the Royal Air Forces. That's right, RAF. So there you go, 101 years old today. Happy birthday, Royal Air Force. On this day in 1902, James C. Penny, J.C. Penny, he opened his very first store ever. Where? Kemmerer, Wyoming. Really? Wyoming? Nobody lives there. Well, very few people. Ha! On this day in 1869, the steam power brake was patented by George Westinghouse. On this day in 1796, the very first elephant ever arrives in the United States from India. Now you know why we have elephants. Thank you, India. And finally, on this day in 1668, 36-year-old John Dryden becomes the very first English poet laureate. And they still use poet laureate to this day, although I don't know what it means. I guess you're like the best poet in the world or something. Well, whatever floats their boat. Poet Laureate, I think it's just another inflated title. Just my opinion. But either way, I think it's time to bring out a couple more songs. We got to bring out the babe and hunk of the day. And I know my mother's going to love this one. Mom, and all you other lovers of Patrick Swayze, it's time to bring out his song, She's Like the Wind, Patrick Swayze with Wendy Frazier, 1987. It's amazing how awesome this guy could sing. And you know what, ladies? He's a pretty dapper looking fella too, eh? Look at that guy. This guy was a good actor, a good singer, and the ladies loved him. The gay men loved him. There you go. Rest in peace, Patrick Swayze, born August 18, 1952. Passed away 2009 from cancer, 57 years old. Definitely sorely missed. I loved him in Roadhouse as well, from 1991. Oh, 1989 Roadhouse, rather. Excuse me. Rest in peace, Patrick Swayze. You were definitely a babe magnet, and you were sorely missed. Yep, we definitely miss him. That was like one of his last public photos he had. Dude could sing, man. No question about that. I was shocked when I first found out years back that he actually sang the song himself and wrote it. He wrote it and sang it. Wow. My mother loves horses. My mother loves Patrick Swayze. Mom, there's a picture for you, huh? How about them apples? I agree. What an awesome song there, Mr. Swayze. There's Wendy Frazier. Ah, what a scene indeed. Classic, baby, classic. Hot stuff, man. Well, that's interesting. Look at that, huh? Lost him much too young, folks. Gone, but certainly never forgotten, the late, great Patrick Swayze. A true legend indeed. And definitely loved by the ladies. And us men certainly respected the hell out of him, too. I certainly know I do. There you go. Patrick Swayze, rest in peace. Peace, my man. Alrighty. Now, it is time for me to bring out a lady I've had a crush on for over 25 years, and I still do. She's freaking gorgeous. We remember this song well. The song is the classic I've had the time of my life. Bill Medley and Jennifer Warnes. Now, Bill Medley was one of the two of the amazing Righteous Brothers from the 60s. And I've actually seen Bill Medley sing in person in Utah. I'll tell you what, Bill Medley, an amazing man indeed. Jennifer Warnes, phenomenal singer as well. But I tell you what, folks, this goddess of a woman, the lovely Jennifer Grey, 53 and still smoking hot. But here you go. I love this picture and a whole lot more. Here comes the song. If this ain't awesome, I don't know what is. Oh, I love that scene. Her in her panties, little half shirt. Jennifer Grey, I mean, just look at her. Yowza. That's her recent picture, folks. I cannot believe she's 53 now. She is still gorgeous. Always had that cute, innocent look that the Love Doctor loves oh so much. In fact, she even did Dancing with the Stars as well later on. I cannot believe she's over 50 there, folks. Isn't that insane? God, I hope I age that well. That's her nowadays. Unfriggin' believable how well this woman is aged. She's probably like me. She probably enjoys life. Could be better with Patrick Swayze, though. Oh, cleavage, indeed. Yowza. I don't know why it's skipping like that. It's kind of weird. Oh. I guess I should have listened to the song. Because I had to download that one. I didn't have it. Yeah. Wow. This song definitely made the movie. Well, one of the parts that made the movie. So sweet and innocent looking. Jennifer Grey. Ah, there we go, baby. That's how I remember, baby. My wife will understand. There's just certain women that we love, that I love. There's certain men that she loves. But hey, we're not going to cheat on each other. Oh, baby. Here comes the scene. Remember? When she jumped up in his arms. That scene that they were trying to do forever and couldn't get it. And they nailed it. That was huge in that scene. I still get goosebumps when I hear that, okay? I need to watch the movie again. I really do. I apologize for the imperfect music. But hey, if I was perfect, I'd be playing third base for the Red Sox because that'd be perfect for me. Gotta have a good sax solo, right? Of course. Yeah, she looks pretty close to the same as she did in 87. It's incredible. Is that her kid? I don't know. Wow. Ah, you know what? I jumped the gun a little bit on that. We remember them singing to each other. Here it comes. She even won approval from her father in this scene. Jerry Orbach. The late, great Jerry Orbach. Well, we remember well in L.A. Law, if I'm not mistaken, that was a show. She almost turns to Botox, but she didn't. Wow, what an amazing woman. Stunningly gorgeous, total sweetheart. That is a woman I would love to meet. The lovely 53-year-old Jennifer Grey. I cannot believe she's 53. But she is. And damn, does she look exquisite. Alright. I think it's been a very successful show. Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Folks, it's time to make a fetus and head out. So everybody take care. Have a wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive my smelly drink, or you might kill yourself or somebody else. And drinking and driving is dumber than being the Yanks fan. And what's dumber than that is rooting for douchebag cocksuckers like Eli. I'm as good as Tom Brady. Yeah, in your freaking dreams. Manning, or men slapping women, or racism, or animal abuse. Things like that are just plain stupid and definitely deserve a big, fat GFY. I had to take a moment to find it because the wind blew it. But folks, your babe and hunk of the day right there, Jennifer Grey, Patrick Swayze. What a show. What a great movie. If you've never seen Dirty Dancing, shame on you. Shame on you. Go watch the movie. Take it from the Love Doctor. A wicked awesome movie that you and your better half, if you're a man. You, it's a great movie for couples. After that, you're going to want to get it on. Like Marvin Gaye sang back in 73. Let's get it on. But I'm out of here, folks. I'll see you tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye.